We're back with our grocery list. I can see that it has 6 rows in it, but I can also see that we need to buy more than one of each item, like our bananas. So I'm not sure offhand how many items we'll end up buying total. And I'd like to know that total number so that when we're cashing out, we could just do a quick check to see if we have the right number of items in our cart. Well, to do that in SQL, we can use what's called an aggregate function. An aggregate function is useful for things like getting the maximum, minimum, sum, and average of values in our database. In this example, to get the total number of items, we'll start with select, then the name of the aggregate function we'll be using, sum, then the name of the column we want, and then from the name of the table we're selecting from. Ta-da! So we can see on the right that the sum is 15, so we should have 15 items in our cart if we got everything correctly. And notice if I go up here and change the number of bananas, because, you know, I'm going to invite my monkey friends over for a jungle party, we can see the sum increase in real time and get bigger and bigger, so we know that we're now going to need 67 items in our cart. Now, we could easily try out other aggregate functions here, because sum's not the only one. So if we wanted to know what is the most that we'll be buying of any one item, then we could use max. See, 56. Those are obviously our bananas. But this information is useful for this case. Let's go back to sum. Okay. Now, what if we wanted to make sure we had the right number of items after each aisle? Well, we can do that in SQL using the group by clause. We add it to the end of a query, specifying the column name to group by aisle. Okay, so now we can see that in one aisle we have 9, another of 1, but I don't actually know which aisle we're getting each of them in. So what we can do there is just add aisle to the beginning of this select. So there you can see, okay, so we're going to get 9 items in aisle 2, 1 item in aisle 4, 56 in aisle 7, and 1 in aisle 12. Awesome. Now, how did that actually work behind the scenes? The SQL engine first did the grouping of the rows based on aisle. So first did this group by, then it summed up the quantity in each of those groups, and then finally it selected the first aisle value that it saw in each group. And, you know, the aisle value was the same for all of them, so we got the aisles back out. But we could have also said name here, and we do see a name for each of the rows, but it's a bit misleading because for some of these aisles, there are actually multiple items in that group, but the SQL engine just picked the first item out of it. So you really shouldn't be using something different from what you're grouping by because you might not get a sensible result. So we'll say aisle, and now that's an accurate presentation of our data. Okay, so great. You've seen aggregate functions, you've seen group by, and now you can efficiently gather useful statistics on your data. Another tool for your SQL toolbox.